And welcome back to Let's Play Batman the Telltale Series. I'm the RPG Chick, now starting episode 2. An old friend becomes a new adversary as Bruce learns more about the Wayne family legacy and Batman escalates the fight against crime and corruption throughout Gotham. Previously on Batman, the Telltale Series.
A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door.
When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Together, we will change Gotham.
Two-faced, kinda.
Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
He's big.
Vicky Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
Carmine Falcone?
Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Your father knew which hands to shake.
Uh-huh.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal?
She's cool.
It's dangerous. Bye, Bat.
Gotta say, so far, this is my favorite Catwoman.
This is Selina.
Depiction. Selina Kyle.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces.
This was cool. Piecing together the evidence
Falcone's
and stuff.
Falcone's calling card.
Looking forward to more stuff like that.
Where are they?
We're all being played in, couldn't you?
Pretty brave guy, huh?
Where's the money?
Either that or stupid.
It's the Waynes.
Denton.
Well, the Waynes are the biggest gangsters in Gotham.
We know, game. We know. I got my Starbucks Frappuccino and I'm ready to go. Didn't the previous episode also start with a helicopter? Wayne Memorial Auditorium. Yeah, more frame rate hits. This is not optimized. I figured Telltale would fix it by now. So every once in a while I'm going to restart the recording.
You don't have to do this.
Hopefully
you
won't notice.
Now, Master Bruce.
I thought I might find you here. The news was upsetting for both of us.
But you should see this.
Mob money?
I know you come here for solitude, Bruce.
More allegations about his ties to the underworld.
This isn't going away.
It's all so public and messy.
This can't be true.
Tell me, all of this is a lie.
I wish I could. There are no angels in Gotham, Bruce. Maybe there never were.
Wow.
I've been dreading this day for nearly 2 decades. I hoped it would never come.
Forget the papers. I want to hear it from you.
The truth is, they were billionaires, Bruce. You can't amass that kind of wealth without making certain moral compromises. It's just not possible. That
I like
kind
his
of money takes
umbrella.
You
kept their secrets.
You kept their secrets for them.
I'm trying to help
true?
You understand.
Then try harder!
I figure they're being framed or something, but
Hill greased the wheels of politics. Falcone was the muscle. Thomas legitimized the whole enterprise with his name. Your father, Hamilton Hill, and Falcone, they were partners.
Really?
Nothing happened in Gotham without them knowing.
And I'm the last to find out.
Falcone, the papers, they were telling the truth. Everyone knew about this but me.
I know it's a lot to take in.
Yeah, a little
bit. I want
bit.
You to know I had my suitcases ready. I couldn't stand to be around your father anymore.
Damn.
But then they were killed, and you were all alone. And I just couldn't walk out the door. Everything I did, everything I've ever done, was out of love for you.
Aww.
I hope you can forgive me.
You see, his umbrella looks like Bat. I'm not ready.
Just give me some time to think it through, okay?
Yeah, maybe I should have chosen another one.
The first time I've been back here since that night. When the police called me to collect you, I thought they'd finally arrested your father.
Hmm.
I couldn't believe a low-life thug like Joe Chill would have the audacity to rob and kill Thomas Wayne.
What, Mr. Freeze?
He was simply too well known. Too big.
Was it Mr. Cold? Dr. Cold? I don't even freaking know. Dr. Freeze? My father had enemies.
If my father was that deep in crime, he would have had enemies.
Well, it's a fair assumption.
Apparently he did.
You don't think. You always said it was a simple mugging. In 20 years, you've never wavered from that story.
Well, the guy's name is Joe Freeze.
I can recall every moment of that night in vivid detail. But maybe that's wrong.
Sometimes we block out things we don't want to face.
Maybe there was some detail I overlooked.
Well, we could look at a side alley. Oops.
I want him standing here.
Oh, he's... yeah.
Right now.
Not here now.
And what would the Batman do with his own parents' killer?
Eat his intestines.
The possibilities are frightening.
Ask him why.
I'd only want to ask him one question. Why? My parents could have given him anything. Why would he just shoot them?
He was stabbed to death in prison. No one mourns for Joe Chill, Bruce.
Oh. Graffiti. Saturday matinee.
He just wanted to protect us.
He thought he was invincible. Sadly, he was mistaken.
It's hard to see him as a criminal.
I can't picture him as a criminal. Not the kind I deal with.
In that moment, he was simply your father.
Right. He was brave and he did protect us. But I don't know, is this established... you know, established continuity, or is this a new slant on things? I don't know anything about Mr. and Mrs. Wayne to know, like, well, this is different from the comics and movies. Everything I've read really doesn't really go into any detail about them, other than they were friggin' rich and they're dead now and he's an orphan and that's it. You know, I got something else I could look at. I'm just looking around. Invisible wall stops me. Talk to him. I'm gonna look at the theater. We're coming from the theater on a dark, rainy night. And this brute came out of the shadows.
I love that movie. Saw it countless times at that theater. How long did it play there?
Which movie?
Only when you wanted to see it, Bruce. Your mother arranged the special screenings personally.
It was called Saturday Matinee.
I never knew that. She was always so good to me.
Master Bruce. The Bat-brella.
Where exactly does the memory end?
With my father pleading, you don't have
Excuse
to do
me?
This. And the gun fires.
And after that?
I cried.
There are considerable gaps in that.
Well, after that, shot his mother after that.
Maybe. Do I really want to know?
He said something to young Bruce before he ran off, too. You don't have to do this. We're in slow motion mode.
Bruce, stay back!
Take whatever you want!
Nothing personal, just business.
Business?
He told me you had it coming.
You don't have to do this.
He was hired by somebody. Yep.
Tell Falcone. He's making a mistake.
This guy's not really professional. He had to shoot him 3 times. 1, 2.
Bruce. Yeah.
1 bullet left for Bruce. Assuming it's a 6-chamber gun. Sloppy way of getting the pearl necklace too, even with some pearls.
Bruce, are you alright?
It wasn't a mugging. They were assassinated.
Yep.
And Carmine Falcone knows why.
So he was an assassin, this Joe Freeze. Really thought he was, Captain Cold? Mr. Freeze? I forget. Gotham City PD, 8:56 a.m. I'm still in bed. It's way too early for me. Oh, Michael Kirkbride.
But getting you in to see Falcone like this? I don't have to tell you how many rules we're breaking.
Hey!
Now, don't get me wrong, I'm always here for you. But this
is the guy from the fountain.
Both in hot water.
He's the guy from whatever
park. I pulled all the strings I had with the lieutenant. This better not come back to bite us.
No one needs to know.
Relax, Harv. No one needs to know. We'll be out of here in no time.
Oh, relax, he says. As if Bruce Wayne won't turn every head in the building. The last time you disappeared behind closed doors with Falcone, the press made us pay. At least tell me what this is about. Look, I'm all for blind support, but I should at least know what I'm getting myself into.
Personal.
This is a personal matter, Harvey.
Fine, don't tell me. But I hope none of this comes back to bite us. I don't want headlines taking away from my debate with Hill.
Gentlemen, we finally put Falcone in his cage. Now, thanks to the information you gave me, Bruce, he won't ever get out.
Whoa, I'm sorry. Information? What information?
That.
Oh, well, I assumed you knew. I was going to contact your office first thing.
Stir it on Falcone.
But everything's been a little busy.
I'll be honest.
I gave him some evidence against Falcone.
More like a catalog of his entire criminal empire.
Yeah, well,
it's a case that'll put Falcone away for life.
Is that a fact?
It's the reason I said yes to this unorthodox request.
We're nothing if not unorthodox.
Nice job bringing in Falcone. Yeah, that son of a bitch better not get off again.
He's not getting off the hook, Renee.
Hope not.
Not this time.
Mr. Wayne, Sergeant Renee Montoya.
Hello, Montoya.
I just wanted to say, you know, some of us police support you, despite what the media is saying.
Thanks, Sergeant.
I like how she only really has an accent.
Keeping Falcone in the infirmary. He's lucky he didn't get roughed up more. I could tell Batman wanted to kill him, but he held back. He cares about doing the right thing.
Haha. We're lucky to have him.
Well, whoever he is behind that mask, I say Gotham's lucky to have him.
He is a freak, though.
It's great to know he's out there watching over the city.
Like a big black.
All right, Falcone's inside.
Bat.
Say what you gotta say. We'll be out here.
Here goes nothing. Those cheekbones, man. Jeez. You must be of European descent. Oh, well, that's the state he's in. Children of Arkham. Let's rough him up a little bit.
The hell? Bruce Wayne? You must have some clout. My own wife can't get in to see me. Good thing I'll be out of here in a week. Just like every other time they tried to put me away.
We need to talk, Falcone.
You weren't so eager the last time we met.
Well, last time I was Batman.
I knew you'd come around. Especially after the press got their teeth into you. You're your father's son.
Not sure how I feel about that.
That's right. Tommy and I were close. More than friends. More like cousins.
I don't want to lead him.
Decades.
Did you have something to do with his death?
Ah. Yeah, you should notice that.
That's what this is really about, eh? The pup digging up a 20-year-old killer.
Two killings. And they were never forgotten.
Right.
You and me. We're practically family.
That's insulting.
I thought you'd figured that out by now. Hey, I tried to get through to you at Dent's party. Maybe I should have spelled it out.
How are we family?
A whole closet full of birthday presents I was never able to give you.
What?
Convince me then. Tell me a story about our big, happy family.
Family of crime.
There it is. Now I got you hooked.
At least you're smiling. Hill, now you made me talk.
And me. We ran this city. Still do. God damn this pain. Can't think through it. Morphine's on the side there. Huh. Be a good boy and help Uncle Carmine out, huh?
Yeah. I don't like the way he said that right now. We need information from him. I want to hurt him, but we need information from him. As if he'd really tell us, but yeah, let's just do it. Let's pump him full of hydrogen peroxide instead.
40 years I keep my veins clean of any of that gunk. But you never forget the tender kiss. It'd be so easy to give me the whole vial, wouldn't it? Enough there to put an old dog down forever.
Well, then we'll never know the truth.
Never know the whole story.
That's what I was saying.
How much of your parents do you have in you? What kind of son did Thomas Wayne make?
Not a murderer.
I'm not a murderer.
No, you're not. That's why you were kept in the dark.
Oh, like a bat.
Much better, kid. Thank you. Just you like that reminds me of your mother. Your father may have been the doctor, but Martha, she had the human touch. Think you got more of her in you, tell the truth. Yeah.
You took her from me.
There's a kindness in you. You care about people. Even mean old bastards like me.
I don't care about you.
Well, I wouldn't know. You took her from me when I was 9 years old.
What, you really think I hired Jill?
You haven't answered me yet.
I worked with Joe Chill from time to time. Put a button on someone, he'd take him out. But I never ordered that hit on your parents.
So who did?
Right.
You can't trust anyone in Gotham. Least of all those you call friend. Your parents learned that.
Oh, what? Hello?
I'm waiting for you in hell!
What the...
I
missed it.
The
Shift E.
Had to die.
Hands in the air. Stand down. Get a doctor. Secure this floor. No one gets in or out. Go. Go.
Are you serious? Shit. She's a police officer and she just busts in and shoots him just suddenly like that. With somebody standing right... That's freaking insane.
We are in deep shit.
She is.
I bought us some time. Deep. But not much.
Shit.
Word's gonna get out. Sooner or later. Why would she do something like this?
You're strong, guy.
We had Gotham's biggest crime lord in our grasp.
Watch that table.
This close. We were this close.
Oh, you think so?
Isn't it obvious? She wanted to shut Falcone up for good.
That's pretty extreme.
This whole damn force is riddled with corruption.
Yeah.
Someone must have got to her, Jim.
It just doesn't make any sense.
Same guy who hired Joe Chill.
She'd never do anything to hurt the department.
Falcone's case meant justice for 1,000 unnamed victims. And now it is a PR disaster. How can I run against corruption when our own cops are redecorating the precinct with their prisoners' brains? Listen, we gotta get out in front of this. We gotta spin it as best we can. Issue a statement saying that we have the shooter in custody. Details are still coming in and that we're investigating. The usual.
Facts.
Slow down, Harvey. We need the facts first.
The simple fact is she walked in and shot him.
Then we need the complex facts, like how and why.
Lieutenant,
Attorney,
Falcone's lawyers are here.
Oh, Christ.
We know how.
I can delay them for a little while, but we still need answers.
Excuse me.
Tell me if she says anything.
Well, now we need to question her.
I have
her.
To know why she did this.
And then before we can get the truth out of her, someone comes in and shoots her twice in the brain.
Alfred, Falcone's been murdered.
Good God.
Good God, man.
I'm looking into it, but I'll need access to the back computer for anything I find.
Connection secured.
Alfred, I'm gonna try and confirm some suspicions of mine.
Damn it, Alfred, I'm a billionaire, not a detective. Let's scan her neck.
Fresh injection site. That doesn't look like blood.
She's being controlled chemically. I wonder if it had anything to do with the chemicals we found in the warehouse. Scan the skin. Oh. Well, it's her lips, right? Ooh.
Her veins. Still visible beneath her skin.
Man, I need a
Alfred,
smartphone
I think I
like
found
that.
The substance. Analyze and forward me the result.
Loop.
Of course. I'll be in touch as soon as I have the results.
Thanks, Alfred. Just contact me on Facebook.
Where am I? Mr. Wayne?
Let me guess, you don't remember anything.
What's going on?
I don't know.
Oh, but I got this awful feeling something terrible happened.
What do you remember?
Everything is such a blur.
Sergeant, you have to think. What do you remember?
Oh, God. Falcone. I was hoping it wasn't real.
I could be happy
I
about those veins.
Drugged, Sergeant.
It would explain a lot. Listen. You have to believe me.
Okay.
I talk big about hurting thugs like Falcone, but I would never, never betray the lieutenant.
Unless...
Everything is so foggy. I remember a sharp pain.
Like a needle?
An injection site on your neck.
Then I just felt light. Like I could do whatever I wanted. No guilt, no consequence.
Oh, wow. They
there
played her.
There was a voice in my ear insisting Falcone was gonna get off. And all I knew was that I had to stop that.
They knew the way she felt.
No matter what. The reasons why I shouldn't.
Remember
they were a million miles away.
You have to remember more, Montoya. Try.
I remember a hand on my arm. Guiding me. Like a parent with a child. The voice, it... was saying something about revolution.
Oh, French revolutionaries. You can watch out for them.
Cobblepot said something similar.
Oh, you think it's Cobblepot?
I'm so sorry, Lieutenant. I've let you down.
We stalled Falcone's lawyers for now, but they'll be back. So how is she? Did she tell you anything?
Yeah, don't worry about that now.
Someone got to her.
Someone used her as a weapon, Harvey. They drugged her and sent her after Falcone.
Hey, get forensics in here. Now!
She remembers a voice saying something about revolution.
That's not much to go on.
No, if you're bringing forensics in, let's get Bruce out.
Viva la revolution!
Alfred, I gotta get back to the manor. I've got a lead on whoever's behind this.
Bruce!
Hi.
What are you doing here? My friends in the GCPD have been telling stories about some kind of lockdown?
I'm in a rush.
I'm sorry, Vicky. I don't have time.
Oh, it's Vicky Valor, right?
Don't brush me off.
Brush. Being
Word
brushed.
There were shots fired near where Falcone was being held.
I'm brushing.
Know anything about that? I mean, you must have been back there when it happened.
Where'd you hear that?
Where did you get that?
So it's true?
No.
No, I didn't say that.
Word is, you turned over enough dirt on Falcone to put him in Blackgate prison for life.
Yeah, well.
A day after he showed up at your house.
Now he's dead, so.
And now you're here. You can't afford to be associated with another scandal. I can keep your name out of whatever we print, but you need to give me something I can use.
Thanks for the concern.
Who fired the shots? A cop? I can tell by the way you're brushing me off that something happened.
Enough time
Just
for this.
Give me something to run with.
Please, get out of my way, Vicky. I'm in a hurry.
Sorry, Vicky.
Disappointing. Maybe you have more to do with this than I thought.
Yeah. I was like his lover and stuff.